Students, let's continue with the register organization of ARM advanced RISC machine. So in the previous video I explained about that ARM register organization. So it's 16 bits, 16 registers will be there. Each register is of 32 bit size. Okay, so whatever from R0 to R15 total, okay, so R0 to R15 is there. From this, R0 to R12 acts as a general purpose register, and R13, R14, R15 are the special purpose register, and CPSR is one of the register. So this each register is of 32 bit size. So whatever the register you are taking, so each register is of 32 bit size. Okay. So let's see. So in the previous video I explained about these registers. Now let's see what is this CPSR. So I said CPSR means current program status register. So this is also one of the special register. So what this current program status register? So let's see the structure. CPSR is a 32 bit register. Okay, from 31 to 28 and 27 to 8, from 7, 6, okay, 5, so let's take 5, 4, 0, okay, let me write. From 31 to 28, it's having N, Z, C, V, and from 27 to 8 is used for, these are unused, which are reserved for the future purpose. From 27 to 8 used for the future purpose. And from here the bit 7 consisting of IF, and bit 6 consist of trap flag, and here this is mode. Okay, so this 27 to 8 is unused, means used for, reserved for future purpose, reserved for future. Now let's see about what is this N. N is nothing but negative flag, negative flag. So this negative flag is set if the result of ALU is negative. Is set if result of ALU is negative. So we are talking about the current program status register. Okay, in the register organization, one of the register is a CPSR register, that is also a 32 bit size. So N is a negative flag, Z is zero flag. So when this flag will be set, this flag is set if result of ALU is 0. ALU is 0. Next, C. C is carry flag. So when this carry flag will be set, this carry flag is set if result of ALU generates carry. If the result is generating carry, then only it sets. So next is V flag is there. V means overflow flag is set if result is overflow. Okay, so that's about these 4 bits, and these are used for the future purpose. Now let's see what is this IF. IF is nothing but interrupt flag. Now let's think about T. What is this T in CPSR? T is, okay, to select thumb state, okay, T is used to select the thumb state. So what is this thumb state? I said this advanced RISC machine consisting of three types of instruction set. One is the ARM instruction set, another is the thumb instruction set, and another is JESL instruction set. So here in CPSR, if T is one of the bit, so one of the registers, so to select the thumb state, if it's set to 1, thumb mode is set, thumb mode is select. Suppose if set to 0, if T is 0, then ARM mode is select. So whenever the T is 1, thumb mode is select. Whenever T is 0, ARM mode is select. So this is referred to as a still the remaining bit was mode. So these are 0 to 4. So what this mode consisting of? So actually there are total 7 modes are there. Total 7 modes can support ARM. The advanced RISC machine can support total 7 modes, so that the selection can be done with the help of this mode. So one of the 7 modes can be selected here. Okay, the total 7 modes, so that I'll explain clearly in the next videos. But the 7 modes are the, let me give overview: user mode, FIQ mode, the fast interrupt request, IRQ interrupt request, and next is abort mode, supervisor mode, undefined mode, and the system mode. So these are all the total 7 modes that can support the ARM architecture. So based on your user requirement, which mode that you are going to be selected, that can be set by selecting any of this mode. So this is referred to as this CPSR, the current program status register, is referred to as a status register or a flag register. And this can be compared to the program status word of 8051. But the major difference for that 8051 microcontroller program status words to this current program status register is the CPSR is a 32-bit register. It is not the 16-bit or 8-bit. It is a 32-bit register. Okay. So this is, so far I discussed only this register organization. So here total R02, R15 will be there, and CPSR is there. So each register is of 32-bit size. Okay. And here it is divided into general purpose and the special purpose. And I explained about the CPSR. Okay. So now in the next video, we'll discuss about the different modes. I said, based on this mode selection only, the ARM can be operated, either it is in a user mode, FIQ mode, IRQ mode, abort mode. So that can be selection on this mode. So these modes I'll explain in the next video. Thank you.